Good morning, dear students. Today, I am going to discussion about the last concept, that last derivation of applications of the Gauss theorem. Say, electric field due to a uniform charged spherical cell. This is one of the important concepts, the derivation that we are going to derive. For the board examination point of view, especially for this derivation, they have been asked for 3 to 4 times. Derive the expression for electric field at a point due to spherical cell using the applications of the Gauss law. So for here, the electric field due to uniform charged spherical cell, there are in which there are 3 possible conditions that we are going to discussion. The first one is the electric field outside the spherical cell. As we know that this is a spherical cell, say the spherical cell or sphere, O be the center of this sphere, R be the radius of this sphere. The simple concept now. I want to find out that electric field due to uniform charged spherical cell outside the spherical cell. The point should be outside the spherical cell. So for here, as we know that, say O be the center of this sphere, R be the radius of this sphere, C, Q be the charges distributed uniformly all around this spherical cell. So these charges, they are distributed uniformly because the shape of this spherical cell is the uniform. The distribution of electric charge also the uniform. See, as usually we studied, we know that Gaussian surface. What is the Gaussian surface? Charges enclosed in a closed surface, that is nothing but the Gaussian surface. So far, Q amount of charges distributed all around this spherical cell. So this is what we call the Gaussian surface. So in this case, the field outside this spherical cell. So let me consider P be the point which is at a distance R from the center of the spherical cell. In the same way, the charges are in equilibrium. How? Why we supposed to say that equilibrium? The distribution of electric charges will be uniform because the shape of this spherical cell will be that uniform. Distribution of electric charges also that uniform now. See, the electric field, what happens now? In this case, if the charge distribution will be equilibrium, so that electric field must be radial in all the points, that is also the same. So, in that Gaussian surface, let P be that point which is at a distance that R from the center O, which is on the Gaussian surface, means the field outside the spherical cell. I want to find out what is the electric field at point P due to this spherical cell, center of the spherical cell, that distance is that R. Try to understand in this case, so far that O be the center, as already we studied, R be that radius, then P be the point on this Gaussian surface, it's a surface area, that is the ds, which is at a distance is that R. R be the small r be the distance from the center of the sphere spherical cell as well as that point P. So far in this case, what is that electric flux? So in this particular consideration, the electric flux through this Gaussian surface, what is the electric flux through this Gaussian surface? Let me know, this is the point P. There must be some small amount of, this is the small area, this area is ds. What happens, what is mean by electric flux? Flux is nothing but number of electric lines of force passing normally through the surface area. There must be some electric flux will be obtained. So far, here the small amount of, see that electric flux means that is how much? That is the d pi. The d pi is the small amount of electric flux. That should be what supposed to know. See, but I want to find out total electric flux on this entire Gaussian surface. See, entire Gaussian surface, the total electric flux, that is what we obtain. So, total electric flux through this Gaussian surface, that is the pi equal to summation of E into ds cos theta. See that electric field, so that electric field, it is also along this surface. So far this is the ds surface area on this particular point. The electric field, that is E, the electric field is also along this particular direction. So far in this case the theta equal to what now? Theta equal to 0. So far cos 0 is, say that is 1. Then total electric flux, summation of E into ds, what we obtain. Cos theta, that cos 0 is, say that is 1. So far, total electric flux pi equal to summation of that E into ds, what we obtain. So far in this case, that also I can write E into summation of ds. That is a total electric flux. So far this is small ds. Like this in the Gaussian surface, there are small points you may be able to consider. Say small flux. Here also small surface area, small flux. Like this, entire this Gaussian surface. So far, total surface area for this Gaussian surface, that is what we call, in this case, let me take how, say, summation of ds equal to 4 pi r square it is. That is total surface area of this Gaussian surface. Surface area of this Gaussian surface. No. Surface area of the Gaussian surface, that is 4 pi r square. Therefore, flux equal to E into 4 pi r square. We call that is equation number 1. Total electric flux on this Gaussian surface E equal to 4 pi r square. Now, we know that Gauss theorem, that Gauss law. Total electric flux in a closed surface is equal to 1 by epsilon times of total charges enclosed in that closed surface. So far, from the Gauss law, total electric flux equal to Q by epsilon. We call it now that equation number 2. Total electric flux, pi equal to 1 by epsilon times of total charges enclosed, Q by epsilon. Then from equation 1 and 2, E 4 pi r square equal to Q by epsilon. I want to find out electric field. 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon Q divided by r square. This is the expression for electric field at a point due to spherical cell. That spherical cell, let me know that the point should be on the Gaussian surface. This is one of the important expression that I would like to explain here. This is the one part. The second part is what now? The second part, the field on the surface of the spherical cell. Say, the second part that I would like to see, derive that one also. That is very important concept also. Let me take, it's a spherical cell. So far, in this spherical cell, it is a sphere. See here, the second one. See, the second part, the electric field. So, electric field on the surface of the spherical cell. Electric field on the surface of the spherical cell. This is also one of the important things. Let me know that O be the center of the spherical cell and Q be the charges distributed uniformly on the spherical surface. Let me know that Q. Here the Q charge is distributed on the surface, hence the surface charge density also. Here the point P, let me take the point P. So far this is the surface area, that's a ds we call it, no? Say this is the R, no? Because the P point, which is at a distance R, because on the surface of the spherical cell, so that distance is, that is R, what we supposed to know. From the previous expression, that what we supposed to know, we have already derived that previous expression, E equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon Q by R square. This derivation already we have derived, that is the expression for electric field. That electric field at a point due to spherical cell outside the spherical cell on that Gaussian surface, that E equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon Q divided by that R square, that is what we supposed to know that. But here the point P on the spherical surface, then R equal to R, here small r equal to capital R, then this R equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon Q by R square. Small r equal to the capital R here, because the point P is on the surface of the spherical cell now. So far in this case, let me know that the charges are there, then there must be surface charge density. We know that sigma is the surface charge density. Surface charge density, already you know that surface charge density sigma equal to what? Q by area. Q by area, say charge per unit area, that is the thing, but the surface charge density we also supposed to take Q by ds also, nothing wrong it now. Entire the surface area, we can also write the surface charge density Q divided by summation of ds. Say surface charge density sigma equal to Q by ds, but from in this particular consideration, sigma equal to Q by ds, summation of ds is nothing but total surface area of this spherical surface now. So for its radius is R, here that's what we supposed to know. Summation of ds is nothing but 4 pi R square, where R is the radius, that's what we supposed to know. Sigma ds equal to 4 pi R square, so then particularly sigma equal to Q divided by 4 pi R square, we get it. So that sigma equal to that particular values we obtain, say Q divided by 4 pi R square, that is what we obtain. So far in this case, Q equal to what? Sigma into 4 pi R square. This is also one of the important concepts. But we have that relation. This is equation number 1 and this is equation number 2. From equation 1 and 2, see E equal to 1 divided by 4 pi epsilon Q is sigma 4 pi R square whole divided by that R square. These two get cancelled, 4 pi get cancelled. E equal to sigma by epsilon. This is the electric field, where electric field on the surface of the spherical cell. This is the second important point, the electric field on the surface of the spherical cell. This is also one of the important, see the derivation now. That last one, say third one, let me take here, say field inside this spherical cell now. Electric field at a point inside the spherical cell. Let me know that. See, electric field at a point inside the cell. It's a very simple concept also. Let me take, this is a spherical cell. As usual, its radius is that capital R. So far, the charges distributed uniformly all around the surface of the spherical cell. Charges Q this is the O. But in this case, the point which is inside this spherical cell, what happens? Inside the spherical cell, so far the distance is that R, this is the point. So far in this case, the point which is inside this spherical cell, what happens? Point inside this spherical cell, which is a distance R from the center of this spherical cell, what happens now? The charge ultimately enclosed by this Gaussian surface is zero in this case. Let me know the charge in the Gaussian surface, charge enclosed in that Gaussian surface in this case. Charge enclosed in a Gaussian surface, is zero. Here Q equal to zero inside this Gaussian surface. So far flux through this Gaussian surface, then therefore flux through this Gaussian surface is pi equal to, what happens? Pi equal to E into 4 pi R square. We supposed to know that. According to that Gauss law, let me take from the Gauss law, pi equal to Q by F naught, but here 0 by F naught now. We call that as equation number 2. Because charges enclosed in this closed surface is 0, hence pi equal to 0 divided by F naught. Yes, from 1 and 2, E into 4 pi R square equal to 0 by F naught, hence that E equal to 0. Means electric field inside this spherical cell is 0. According to that Gauss theorem, that what we have been studied here, these are all the most important concepts, that is what we are supposed to know. But you must know that in this case, electric field, where it is maximum, electric field must be maximum on the surface of the spherical cell. So it is the minimum, it should be the zero where it is the electric field inside this spherical cell now. As usual, we compare with that capital R as well as R. Let me take that R is the radius, small r is the distance where actually the electric field in that particular Gaussian surface now. Ultimately, what we came to know that how exactly it is. For example, if R is less than small r, there must be some electric field. Means what? Electric field which is at distance that r is less than capital R, means outside this spherical cell. If that r equal to that r, it is on the surface, on the surface of the spherical cell. If r is greater than r, in this case, so far this is what we supposed to know, that electric field will be zero. So how exactly that variation with the distance, that we came to know that how. This is the last concept in this applications of the that Gauss theorem or Gauss laws. So far this completes that particular electric charges and electric field topic. So you try to understand all the concepts on these particular topics now. Just I will brief that entire this particular topic, the concepts you try to understand, the properties of electric charge and Coulomb's law, electric field, electric dipole, and also the electric field lines, electric flux, and Gauss law, applications of the Gauss law. This completes this electric charge as well as electric field topic. In the next session, that I would like to discussion about the numericals. So for the board examination, there is some option, say either they may be able to ask 5 marks question or numerical. In the next session, that I will discussion about to solve that numericals. Thank you.